Jason Klobnik, and welcome to episode 4 of Conversations with Myself. We're in the middle of the COVID-19 2020 pandemic, and as much as I love playing with bands and with my band, Jay's Ruckus or the JKQ, and doing collaborations online during this time, I also like to have musical conversations with myself. So this is episode 4, which is the unofficial introduction to the summer season of 2020, hence the sleeveless shirt, the sunglasses, and a feel and a groove that to me kind of represents the summer season, especially here in the Denver, Colorado area. So what I do inside of these videos on YouTube is dive into the what and the how of these conversations. So if you have seen the original video, which I just played, either on Instagram or Facebook or TikTok or any of the other places that I might post the video, this is where we take a little bit deeper dive. So the melody inside of this is completely improvised from the first trumpet, and that's the one that's in that upper left-hand corner, the one without the sunglasses. My kids were asking, "Dad, why did you do 3 other trumpets with sunglasses and then 1 trumpet without?" And to be honest, I forgot to put sunglasses on the very first trumpet. And that's actually the first take that I did. And then after that, it was, do I redo that and put some sunglasses on, or do I leave it alone? And I decided to leave it alone just because I thought it might be interesting. And visually, it gives you something different, so you know that that's the trumpet that's doing the main melody as well as the solo break. So if you're ready, let's dive into my Logic Pro 10 session so you can get a look at what I was doing with the loops and kind of see what I'm doing. Inside of Conversations with Myself, episode 4, looking inside of the Logic Pro 10 session. And these are the different loops that I used to create this week's conversations. I've decided to go through the different loops options that Logic Pro comes with. I just picked a genre. I picked hip hop and went through and found a drum beat first, which happened to be this Chronicles beat. Then from there, I actually started in this descending order with the exception of the arpeggio. I added that last, this countdown arpeggio. But I went the Chronicles beat, started with a beat, then found a guitar part that I liked, actually decided to shift the beat over 2 bars and start with this Crossroads synth bass line along with the guitar part, but that's actually later on down the road in the decision-making process. But I started with the beat, added the guitar, then found a bass part, not in the bass section, but actually in a synth section, because every once in a while, you can find some really cool bass things inside of the synth loops section. And then felt like it needed something else, so I added this countdown arpeggio, listened to all of them together back and forth, and then decided, what if we started with this bass synth line and the guitar, then added in the beat, and when the trumpets come in, let's bring the arpeggio in. And you don't want to have everything completely monotonous going all the time. So right before the solo section, did a little break with the arpeggio and did a break with the drums while keeping the guitar and keeping the bass going. Then I decided to layer the different trumpet parts. So this is where I have the four different trumpets, trumpet one, trumpet two, trumpet three, and trumpet four. And the trumpet one has the solo section on it. And then for those that are interested to see how I mixed, I decided to take trumpet two and trumpet three and pan them pretty hard left and right, and then panned the guitar loop a little bit to the left to provide some sonic separation from the arpeggio, and just enough to where it's not all the way over where trumpet two and trumpet three are at. Trumpet four, I decided to leave center along with the drums, the bass, the synth bass, and the main trumpet. Not sure why I decided to leave it completely center in terms of pan, but liked how it turned out. And you can kind of see where my faders are at. And then on the master channel, or excuse me, the stereo out master channel, using the Ozone 9 elements to help master. So this is what the Logic Pro session looks like. So for next week's video, I would love it if you leave a comment down below if you have any ideas of what you would like to see me do with this. Would you prefer to see all trumpet ensembles and no Logic 10 loops? Or do you like the Logic 10 loops, but you'd like a different style? Or if you're another creative and you have something that you'd like me to add into the conversations with myself, we could call it conversations with myself. And I know it's a little redundant, but hey, we're in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic. This is a great way for musicians to connect and collaborate. I would love if you would send me something to work off of. If you have a loop or if you have a sample that you could send over to me, I can include it into something or just completely build off of what you are sending me. But either way, would love to get your feedback. Leave a comment down below and we'll be sure to include it in a future video. If you haven't already, make sure you're hitting that subscribe button down below. And that bell that's right next to it lets you know when future videos are coming out, whether they're going to be conversations with myself, future Jay's Ruckus videos, JKQ videos, or any of my jazz improv courses and tips and tricks, all the different things that are inside of this YouTube channel. That bell lets you know when future videos are coming out if you don't have a chance to check out the video when it posts. So if you've enjoyed this video, make sure that you like, subscribe, share with other musicians and friends that might enjoy it. And as always, I'll see you next time.